My name is Mohammed Amin Mansour. I'm a carpenter, but IT engineer by profession. I completed Edumahen SHS in 2009. From school, just don't know what the future lies for me. So IT is a hot cake in the market, so I consulted with my mom, so I joined IPMC in August 2009, just 3 months after I completed SHS.
Mohammed Amin had always admired his grandfather and desired to follow his steps as a successful carpenter. He realized his part-time job as a systems administrator was not paying off. His grandmother, Hajia Auraba, was his immediate good Samaritan who supported him financially to make ends meet.
It's easy with my parents, but for my grandmother, she understood because I sometimes go for her for tea and tea before I leave for work. And from here to Konfanochi, every day will cost you nothing less than 7 to 10 cedis. You will take your breakfast, lunch. For supper, it will be ready before I reach home. So let's say 15 to 20 cedis a day, it can't balance the equation. Due to this financial, so I decide that's the main reason why I quit.
Mohammed Amin decided to go back to the drawing board and start all over again. He spent most of his free days monitoring his grandfather's carpentry work located near the family home. Mohammed Amin developed interest in the carpentry work. Opportunity presented itself one day when his grandfather asked him to try out furniture making.
His shop was situated in front of our house. So right from work or school, I used to come there and sit. Whilst he is working, I started picking, but never informed him that I want to do carpentry. Whilst he was doing, hold this for me, do that for me, just he think I was helping, but I was acquiring the knowledge. So when I stepped forward and said, I want to, he said, can you? And I said, yes, I've been learning from what you are doing. So he just said, then this is a stuffing chair that somebody brought. Do it. If you succeed, I will pay you. If you spoil it, then I will pay it back. So it's like a gamble. I did it, and lo and behold, that's the beginning.
Between 2013 and 2014, Mohammed Amin decided to convert a small part of his family home into a shop.
Then boys, ghetto life. Though I wasn't from a ghetto, but I have brothers who live in the ghettos. Oh, do this for me. 2015, Baba Ma, I have a friend, Baba Ma and Ama. We used to call him Why Worry. They gave me their room set to do. Since it comprises of a chair, wardrobe, bed, TV stand, I did it. And people passing by, because I have displayed it in front of my house, so people saw it and, oh, it's good, you keep it up. So it just began. Then the morale just came on fully.
He received 300 cedis a month as a systems administrator, but now makes an average 3,000 cedis a month. The Amin Furniture has 6 apprentices, and he has built a platform that attracts over 500 customers across the country.
From this same work, inshallah, I have a wife. I take care of my wife after giving her what she needs, my own. That's why I said, for a month, if I'm to say it's a salary, I will get 3,000.
Mohammed Amin says he is no longer interested in taking up computer engineering as a full-time employment because of opportunities to serve many clients with his furniture works.
It's not always what you learn that will take you to the promised land. Never depend on what you have yesterday and say that it will hold you for tomorrow. No. Just look at the market. Just look at the market, the trend, and pursue what you think will help you best. And carpentry, because Ghana is a developing country. Developing country, people are building houses. Contractors are on field. So carpentry, the market for carpentry is there.
When Mohammed Amin decided to follow the steps of his grandfather, some family members opposed his carpentry venture. His mother, Hajia Harissa Amin, was disappointed in her son for failing to pursue his career as a computer engineer. 9 years after making the move, Mohammed Amin says he has no regret.
I've never regretted, and I thank God for this guidance.
He hopes to emerge as one of the largest furniture producers in the country. A report by Mohammed Nuruddin.